So let's talk a little bit about this project before launching it. And I made this little logic project, or little. I have a lot of Alchemy plugins loaded in this project. It's like 10 different patches of Alchemy. And on each of these Alchemy patches, we also had a space designer. And the reason for adding this Alchemy plugin is that it's if you're working Logic, you know that this is a quite demanding plugin, both in the graphical user interface and for the CPU. So that's why I loaded up 10 different versions of the Alchemy plugin. And we have the Space Designer, which is also a quite CPU demanding plugin. So we have an Alchemy, Space Designer, and a compressor here on most of these tracks. And we also have a few chroma reverbs and some quick samplers here and the regular sampler. And someone asked me if I could add a few more audio tracks, and that's what I've been doing here. So I've been recording some guitars yesterday evening for this project, and it worked just fine, no hiccups at all. And I added some additional drums here to them. Let's play this project back and see how it performs. But again, bear in mind that I'm streaming from this laptop at the same time. So OBS is probably eating up a lot of CPU, and yeah, you can see that if I open the activity monitor here, it's like 164% of the CPU. So that's a quite demanding software to run, especially on a laptop. I actually tried to stream from my previous MacBook Pro a few times, the 15-inch from 2016, but I always had hiccups when trying to stream from that one, but it seems to go fine so far with the Apple M1. So let's close this down and play back the project here. Right, so that's the little project that I made for the Apple M1 video to test the performance of Logic Pro in with the Apple M1 CPU. And as you saw here, the CPU was going a little bit higher here in this case. But again, I'm streaming from this same laptop at the same time as running this quite demanding project. And as you saw here, we have some audio projects this time, which we didn't have in the previous video. And we also have a few of these Vital plugins loaded. And as you see, if I open up the Vital plugin like this, you have a little loading icon. And at that point, we have that Rosetta software translating the x86 code into ARM64 code. So we can also see that if we open up the activity monitor, we have this AU hosting compatibility service running. And that's running under the Intel architecture, which means that we have some of these plugins in this Logic project are not, they are not written for ARM64, the new M1 architecture, but they are rather written for the old Intel architecture. So we don't have the full performance in these plugins, but you saw there, I could play this track just fine without any hiccups. So that's really what I'm trying to say with this little project, that it's totally possible to do quite elaborate projects on this little neat minimal laptop. Right, so let's look at some questions here. Track sounding good. Thank you, John. John Boy Bliss, welcome. Hi there, Alexi. Good to see you. How are you? Long time no see. Suddenly you're in time for the live stream. So unexpected.